Hunter came into my life specifically to be a working dog. He's responded to multiple hurricanes and tornadoes with me over the past decade. I believe that every dog has a purpose, but our working dogs are more than just pets. They're our partners, and we ask them to do things that humans can't do. I noticed that he had a slight limp. I was worried that he might have torn his knee, which is a common thing for our working dogs. So I went into my local veterinarian and they were of the same mindset. He's probably overdone it. Let's just monitor and give him some anti-inflammatory. And I said, no, I don't care what the expense is. Please go ahead and x-ray all four legs and his spine. And the veterinarian came back with tears in her eyes and told me that it was most likely cancer in his front leg.
Dogs, just like humans, get cancer spontaneously. They grow and metastasize and mutate just like human cancers do. I'm an immunologist at Yale. More recently, we have really applied what we've learned in the immunology of other diseases towards cancer. About one in four dogs will get a cancer over time. There are very few novel cancer immunotherapies for the treatment of dog cancers. So we began developing a therapeutic vaccination. Our early studies included a number of very interesting patients. Among them, a golden retriever that was trained to find survivors in catastrophic building collapses, and it got a fairly serious bone cancer, had to have amputation of the affected limb. I was contacted by the owner if they could get involved in our clinical trial. Indeed, they did.
I knew that I wanted to approach Hunter's cancer diagnosis as an integrative process. I consulted with Mark, I consulted with oncology team at Ohio State University's Veterinary Hospital. It's horrifying to consider amputating a dog's limb, especially a dog who a few weeks ago was running around on a rubble pile searching for victims. But a lot of friends who are veterinarians said he's a perfect candidate. I did the first vaccine before the amputation, and then I did the second vaccine after the amputation, but before we started chemotherapy.
35% of dogs with osteosarcoma will live 12 months after diagnosis. And that's with conventional therapy. Adding our vaccination immunotherapy to that almost doubles the probability of survival in this particular type of dog cancer.
There's the barking.
I'm really happy to say that Hunter is 22 months post-diagnosis and he is full of life. And I know just how fortunate I am. Had I not been connected with Mark, it wouldn't matter how much money I had. That vaccine, if it didn't exist, it wouldn't have been there as part of his care.
My own dog passed away of an inoperable cancer about 11 years ago now. Dogs, just like humans, suffer greatly from their cancers. If we can provide some benefit, some relief, pain-free life, that is the best outcome that we could ever have.
Good boys. Thank you.